towel comes out of the womb.
Noah and Ivy Cleveland were supposed to be on a flight to China Friday night to pick up their adopted daughter.
We had this made for her to wear on her adoption day.
Instead, they and their two sons spent Friday evening showing us the baby room they spent months preparing for 3-year-old Ruby Faith's homecoming.
What we also got is dolls right here. And
the Clevelands spent 2 years in an often unpredictable adoption process. They finally got the certainty of booked plane tickets, hotel rooms, only to have their adoption agency tell them less than 2 weeks before meeting their daughter that plans were on hold because of the coronavirus outbreak. This was just days before the U.S. announced restrictions on people traveling from China.
This was the first time in my life that I truly wept to the point of being sick in my body. I just laid over her bed, over her crib that I had, you know, prepared for her, and looked up at the pictures on the wall and her clothes in her closet, and just understanding that this is not happening right now.
The State Department says adoption cases are still being processed, though they advise adoptive parents not to travel to China for the time being.
Our two boys were staying here, and so I had 6 different babysitters lined up to care for them for the 14 days we would be gone.
This is our suitcase all over the country as we've traveled.
And because plans in this house often involve Noah Cleveland's out-of-town tours performing Christian music, the sudden change in logistics is also costly. More importantly, it's stretching their faith.
I know by my story and my life that there's many things I wouldn't have signed up to go through, but at the end, the way that God works it out, I would never trade it. And I know this is just a part of our story. It's a part of Ruby's story, and how incredible will it be to be able to tell her, look what we did to fight for you.
What they did to fight for a girl who they say was abandoned in a hospital bathroom when she was 6 months old, a girl who's diagnosed with hydrocephalus.
And Daddy built this sign.
A girl whose new middle name is Faith, the very thing her family is relying on right now.
If you could say something to her that she would understand right now, what would you want her to know from you?
Mom and Daddy's coming. Just wait, we'll be there soon.
Natasha Chen, CNN, McDonough, Georgia.